Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Friends, welcome back to my channel. While working on a device, I found this transistor bed. How we can test a transistor in proper way, either it is SMD, either it is signal, medium power, RF, medium power and power transistor. It is BJT, bijunction transistor. I will share a very easiest way. If you will watch this video, I guarantee that you will never forget the transistor testing, and it will be a confident method. First of all, pick the transistor and see its pinout and mark it on paper. Here it is index, then we have pin number 1, 2, 3. So 1, 2, 3, we will mark like this. Make a table here. Now we will use multimeter. Any type of transistor, any one you have. If you are going to test a power transistor, you will see there is a distance gap, there is a gap difference between the leads and the mounting. Here it have less distance, here is more distance, so you can differentiate. If it is like this transistor, you can differentiate, put the part number in front of you, 1, 2, 3 like this. Same here, 1, 2, 3, and there is difference. If there is RF power transistor, then we have one lead connected to the body, two are insulated. Just to remember, make its marking. Now, set multimeter to diode mode. We are now in diode mode. You can also check in resistance mode. Here we have two leads, red and black. Basically, when we say multimeter, the black lead, that is common. But now we are going to make it as a common. Connect to one pin, any one pin, start from one side. So this is pin number 1. I am connecting black lead, black lead at pin number 1. So this is common pin. Now check the voltage drop between pin 1 and 2. It is 0.686. 0.686. Connect to pin number 3. Don't move pin 1, that is now common. OL. Now move this common lead to pin number 2. So black at pin number 2. So this pin is now common. Black common. Connect red lead at pin number 1. It is OL. Now move this lead to pin number 3. It is OL. Open circuit. Now move the black lead to pin number 3. Remember your pin assignment when you have marked it. Now black lead at pin number 3. So this pin is now common. Connect between 3 and 1. Open. Open. And connect 2. It is 684. 0.685 volt drop between pin 3 and 2. Here it was pin 1 and 2, now 3 and 2. Now we completed this common, shifting to each pin. Now we will swap the leads the same way. We will make common red wire. Now red at pin number 1. In the same way, connect black lead to pin number 2. Now it is common. Now it is OL. Connect to pin number 3, OL. Move our selected common, that is red lead, to pin number 2. Check between pin number 1 It is 0.689. Now connect between 2 and 3. It is 687. 0.687. We will verify again. 692. Its resistance is changing due to change in temperature. The one lead have more resistance. The second have low voltage drop, less voltage drop. It is 692. 689. If it is 0.692, it is 0.689. That is the same. Common. Okay. 690. The one is slightly high, the second is slightly low. This one is high, 689, 687. 689, 687. Now move the lead to pin number 3. Now move the selected lead to pin number 3. Now connect between 3 and 1 the same way here. Open, red at 3, 3 is common now, 3 and 1 open, 3 and 2 open. In these complete measurements, now we will see, when we connected black at 1, this pin was common. One junction was giving some voltage drop, second was open. Here open, one junction was giving resistance, this was common. Just only we have one condition, that is here. In these six steps we have just only one condition, that at that point pin number 2 was red. Pin number 2 was red. What is that? This is pin number 2, it is red, one side have 692, the second side 690. We have just only one condition, when our red lead was at the center pin, which we defined here, this end it have more resistance, voltage drop, and this one is less. This pin is black. Black, red, black. Here we have more voltage drop, here we have less voltage drop. If we see, red lead is at positive, black at common. In the same way, we will decode it here. The black color shows negative N. P N. So this is NPN transistor. Now see here, between this pin and this pin we have more voltage drop. Between the common and the left one, this pin and the left pin, 691, 0.691, and the right side it have 689. So the more voltage drop between emitter to base and low voltage drop between base to collector. So now we can say this pin is emitter, this is the base, and the right pin, that is collector. Two N series transistors, these have a marking on the body that this pin is emitter pin and the collector is connected to body. So emitter, collector, the remaining is base. But using multimeter you can verify in this way. Now this one, the same transistor here, I found it bad in one circuit. Repeating this step, this side it is open, this side it is 0.570. Base to emitter junction open, open circuit, here it is 0.70. Reverse the lead between these two, it is 0.72. So collector to emitter junction have also damaged. Base to collector junction is also damaged, base to emitter is open. So this transistor was bad, I was going to replace it. So I demonstrated in this way you can verify any transistor. For example, here you will repeat 6 steps with the chassis, it is giving 0.62619 and here it is 0.667. So high resistance between base to emitter, the low resistance between base to collector. In this way we can verify any transistor. Now if we see it deeply, this is the positive terminal, so this is the negative terminal. We can say we have one junction here between this point to this point and one junction here. When we will connect negative to positive here, this diode is forward bias. If we swap the leads, it is reverse bias. Here forward bias, here reverse bias. Just only there will only one condition when both diodes will be tested by making common this lead here and here. In first condition, when we make black lead common at pin number 1, the first diode, it was being tested here, it was open circuit, so it was good. Now move the common to this point, this is open, this is open, so both are good. If we see, move common to rightmost pin, here it is, here it was open circuit and here it was testing one diode between 3 to 2, so it was good. Now move red lead to pin number 1, cathode, anode, reverse bias, reverse bias, two diodes back to back. Then red lead at pin number 2, here this one, this one, forward bias, forward bias. Move this lead to this position, so number 1, 3 to number 1, open, open. Only there was one condition, that when we place this lead here, this is forward bias, this is forward bias. If we find any diode in this way, both side continuity, that means that diode is bad, as we see here. So this diode junction damaged, and if you test with ohmmeter, in that case if you place in the this in the center pin base with emitter, it is 431 kilo ohm. Base to collector, base to emitter 450 k. Base to emitter high resistance, base to collector low resistance. Always if you test with ohmmeter, here low resistance between base to collector, because collector always provides high current, so internal resistance must be low, base to emitter resistance must be high. There will a slight difference between both values. I hope so this video is informative. If it is informative, hit the like button. If you have any question, let me know in the comment box. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.